On to the floods in Nepal. Torrential rainfall caused landslides and flooding in various parts. Heavy rains have triggered flash floods in several districts. About 133 people were rescued as rains are eroding the embankments, putting settlements at a high risk. Transportation has also been disrupted in all major highways of the Himalayan nation. Police have also been evacuating residents from flooded homes in rubber boats in some parts of Kathmandu where roads were flooded. According to police reports, more than 24 people are still missing and at least 11 have been injured as the death toll rises in the districts. Nepal's weather department has warned people to stay alert as rains are supposed to continue for the next 2 days now. Nearly 150 people died last year in Nepal during the rainy season, which typically begins in late June and lasts until the end of August. Floods continue to wreak havoc in parts of China as well, as provinces continue to reel under torrential rainfall. The flood death toll has now risen to 61. 356,000 people have been evacuated from their homes. 4 million hectares of farmland have also been damaged. A new round of rains in the eastern provinces triggered flash floods in the region. The flooding situation in the city's rural areas was worse than the urban areas, with houses and farmlands being underwater. The local Met Center has issued an orange alert for rainstorm, the second highest level warning in the country. Heavy rains are also expected in parts of southern China. Urban areas of southern China are waterlogged from the continuous rainfall that has battered the region. 42 stranded residents and 65 tourists were also rescued from towns in the area. Traffic on major roads also interrupted due to heavy landslides. China suffers from floods every year in the southern region as the north suffers from droughts. Hurricane Barry made landfall in Louisiana on Saturday. The hurricane, however, reduced into a tropical storm as it approached the shores. But the wind still running at 75 miles per hour, downed trees and power lines across New Orleans. Streets and businesses were flooded in various places as heavy rains lashed the area. The Mississippi River crested at just under 5.18 meters. This was much lower than the prediction that was made at 6.1 meters. Even though the threat of major flooding in the historically high running river seems to have passed, the storm is still deemed dangerous. Louisiana's governor has asked people to stay vigilant as the storm is expected to gain strength while moving northwards. A state of emergency has already been declared in Louisiana. Relief and rescue operations are being carried out while the residents have been asked to stock up provisions and look for shelters. The weather services have predicted significant flash flooding and river flooding as the hurricane would move further inland. The hurricane, though, is expected to wane into a tropical depression by Sunday.